This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, let's start. Yeah, hope it's audible to everyone. Okay.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. So in the last class, we have seen how to create the table by using data elements and domains, and we have generated the table maintenance by providing the maintenance type as the two steps. Then we have created the T code for the table, we have maintained the table, and also we have discussed how to implement events as part of a table level. Okay, so in continuation to this dictionary objects, let us see indexes on database tables. Okay, indexes on database tables. Right. So what is the meaning of an index? Index is nothing but what? It is a process of arranging the data in an order. Okay, so index is nothing but process of adding the data in an order. So when the data is in sorted order, the searching would become what? Fast. Okay, the main agenda of indexing is to increase the searching speed. Okay, so when you have huge amount of data, if you want to search for any specific record in that particular huge amount of data, okay, we are going to what? Sort the data, and then we are going to search. Just like if you take our internal tables, okay, before using the read statement on internal tables, it is recommended to sort the internal table based on the search field. So by using sort statement, we are going to sort the data, and then we are going to search the record by using what? Read statement. Similarly, on database tables also, we can implement what? Indexes. So the agenda of indexes, it is going to arrange the data in an order based on a particular field. So basically, we have two types of indexes. One is primary index, another is what? Secondary index. Okay, so we have two types of indexes, primary index and what? Secondary index. Primary index, we don't have any control on that. Okay, primary index is automatically created by SAP itself. Okay, this primary index is created by SAP itself based on what? Primary key field. So already we know in ABAP, every table should have what? Minimum one primary key and maximum what? 16 primary key fields. So on top of that particular primary key field, SAP itself will create what? Primary index. In the sense, internally, it will arrange the data in an order. Okay, based on that primary key field, it will arrange the data in an order so that whenever we search for the record based on the primary key field, SAP will make use of what? Primary index. I repeat once again, we have two types of indexes, primary index and secondary index. Primary index is automatically created by SAP itself. We don't have any control on that. Okay, so internally, it is going to arrange the table data in an order based on the primary key field so that whenever we search for the record based on the primary key field, SAP will make use of primary index to search for that particular specific record. Okay, so as a developer, we have control only on what? Secondary index. Okay, so this secondary index should be created by whom? By developer. Okay, and we create this generally on what? Non-primary key fields. Okay, secondary index, we create them on what? Non-primary key field. So let's see how to create the secondary index. So why we have to create the secondary index is to improve the performance. Okay, in the sense, when I'm retrieving the data, when I'm using the select statement, okay, so when I'm retrieving the data using select statement, and as part of my select statement, assume that we have some where class where we are going to search on what? Non-primary key fields. So to improve the performance of this particular select queries, we can create what secondary index and what non-primary key field. So in your project, assume that we have multiple scenarios where we are trying to retrieve the data from a particular table, but based on what non-primary key field. So to improve the performance of the report, one of the ways what to create the secondary index, so that when we use the select statement comparing non-primary key field, it makes use of secondary index, which will retrieve the data what in a very much what a faster way, right? And again, the secondary index we can classify into two types. One is unique secondary index, another is non-unique secondary index. Okay, so I repeat, secondary index we can classify into two types: unique secondary index and non-unique secondary index. Okay, so as the name itself suggests, unique secondary index means, suppose if I create, if I create unique secondary index on a field, it will not accept duplicate values for that particular field. Okay, non-unique means it can hold what duplicate values. So already we know primary key field by default doesn't accept what duplicate values. Suppose if you want a non-primary key field also, where the duplicate values should not be accepted, then we can create what unique secondary index. So whenever we create that, it will not accept but duplicate values. So let us see how to create the secondary indexes. So I'll consider one table. Like assume that I'll take our own table. I'll go to ABAP dictionary. Suppose I'm having a table Z9MEMP, some table. Okay. So this is a table. This is what table? Client independent table. This table doesn't have what? MANDT column. Okay, so it is client independent table. It has got some four columns. Primary key field is what? Employee number. So internally SAP would have created what primary index based on this particular field. We cannot see that primary index physically. Okay, SAP will make use of primary index whenever we execute the select statement comparing with what primary key field. So we don't have any control on that. So now what I want is, I want to create secondary index. Okay, let me create secondary index on what employee name. Generally secondary index are created on what non-primary key field. So I'll create it on employee name. Let me go for creating. Okay, do we have any data in this first? Yeah, we are having some 16 records. So this is the data. Okay, this is the data I'm having. So let me try to create unique secondary index on this particular employee name, right? So I'll go to content. Sorry, how do you create? So open your table either in display mode or change mode in SC11. Then here on the application toolbar, you can see we have a button what indexes. Okay, we have the button indexes. Let me click on indexes button. Done. So when you click on the indexes button, yeah, here you can see we have a button create. I'll click on create index. Index name it is asking. So this is a table. It is asking the index name. I'll give the index name as something. You can give any name. I'll give it as something ID 1. Okay, ID 1. This is the index name. Continue. Done. Short description. Secondary index on employee name. So what is the mess? Excuse me, please.
Hello. Everyone, who is this? Okay. Yeah, tell me. அக்கேனுடும் வந்து அக்கேனு காலமே ஆஃப்டர் 9 o'clock ஐ மீன் த கிளாஸ் 9 o'clock ஆனா இட்ஸ் நாட் இட் பிளான்ட் யா காலமே 9 o'clock கழிச்சு
Right. So where we are? So this is the short description I gave. Done. So you can see as of now it is saying that the status is new. Index does not exist in the database system but MS SQL. Done. So you have two radio buttons here, non-unique index and unique index. Okay. So let me go for non-unique index means already we know it can hold what duplicate value. So let me go for unique index. Okay. Unique index, it is asking the field name. So let me choose table fields. Yeah, on which field you want to create? Employee name. Creating secondary index on primary key field doesn't make sense. Okay, creating secondary index on primary key field doesn't make sense because already primary index will be available on what primary key field. So as a developer, we always go for what? Creating the secondary index on non-key field. So I'll go for what? Employee name. So I'm selecting employee name, continue, done. Let me check, save it, check for the syntax error, no errors, activate your index. Warnings occur during activation. Do you want to display? Yes. Yeah, index is what? Activated. Index is activated, fine. Let me go back. Object is activated. Index does not exist in the database system. It is saying active, but it is saying not activated. Why? Let me activate once again. Warnings occur during activation. Do you want to display? Yes. One second. Let me check this. Error creating the index also in the database. Okay, it is not giving any meaningful error. Okay, I'll do one thing. Let me go back. This saying object is active, but it is saying index does not exist in the database system. I'll just go back. Okay, let me just delete this once. I'm deleting this. I'm deleting the index. Let me check the contents here. Yeah, this is the data. Probably what I believe is employee name, there are some records whose employee names are blank. Whose employee names are blank. Okay, unique secondary index means what? It doesn't accept duplicate values. So probably this could be the problem. So what I'll do is let me try to delete them. So I'll choose table entry delete. This record will be deleted. Database record deleted. Then I'll select this record also. Table entry delete. Let me also delete this record. Table entry delete. Done. So this is the data available. As of now, we have only one record whose employee name is not blank. Anything repeated here? Okay, no employee name is repeated. Fine. Now I'll try to create what unique secondary index on what employee name. So I'll click on indexes, create index. I'll give the index name as ID1, provide the description. Secondary index on employee name, done. I'll choose what unique index. I'll choose unique index, table fields. I'll select employee name, done. Let me save, check for the syntax error, activate this. Good. Object is not activated. What it is saying now? Index exists in the database system. The database configured to this SAP server is what? MS SQL. Okay. So the index is successfully created now. Index is successfully created. Done. What type of index it is? Unique index. Okay. Unique index. Now what I'll do is, since it is a unique index, I cannot enter what duplicate values. So what I'll do now, I'll say utilities, table contents, create entries. I'll give the employee number something 69. I'll give the employee name something Ramesh Verma something. I'll give some designation. Let me provide the department number also. Then I'll click on save. Yeah, database record successfully created. Now let me give what so and so. Okay, before that, let me check the contents here. Yeah, this is the data, and already you can see there is an employee name by name what Vivek. Okay, I'll try to insert what duplicate employee name. So table contents create entries. I'll give some employee name. I'll give it as employee number is 8890 Vivek. I'll give some designation. Then I'll give the department number. Okay, when I click on save, a data record with the specified key is already existing. A data key with a specified key already existing. One second. I'll go to contents. Yeah. So you can see employee number 890 is not there, but I think the problem is that this Vivek only. Understood? So it is giving a, it is not allowing me to insert what? Duplicate values. Okay, create entries. Employee number I'll give once again 790. Employee name I'll give it as Vivek. Designation I'll give supervisor. Department number let me give it as 30. I'll save it. A data record with the specified key is already existing. Actually, I'm expecting a runtime error, but it's not giving me the runtime error. It is not giving me the runtime error, probably because this is not the table maintenance. If this is a table maintenance, then it would have given what runtime error. Okay, so let me quickly check whether it will give the runtime error in the table maintenance. Am I clear what I am trying to say? Here, employee name Vivek is already available. Okay, so it is simply giving a message saying that data key is already available, but I'm expecting a runtime error. So it's not giving the runtime error. So I'll do one thing. Let me quickly generate the table maintenance for this. Do we have table maintenance already? Table maintenance generator. No, we don't have. Okay. One second. I'll generate the table maintenance. Before that, I require a function group. This is a different server. So let me create a function group. Z645 F group 1 I'll take. One second. Yeah, function group is created. So before I start using it, let me activate once. Z645 F group 1. So what I have to do now, let me generate the table maintenance. I'll go back to the table. This is a table. I'll choose utilities table maintenance generator. I'll give the function group Z645 F group 1. Done. I'll go for two step. Let me propose the screen numbers. Already we know all these things, so I'll just yeah, table maintenance is not generated, right? So let us go to SM30 and maintain the table. So I'll go to SM30, right? So this is a table. I'll click on maintain. Table is cross client, nothing but client independent. Cross client, you got client independent. Okay, so this is my overview screen. So already you can see we have the employee name what Vivek. So I'll click on new entries, enter a valid value. Why? Okay, here this is because of that. Done, because I'm having the what set of values here. I can choose only these values, so it is validating in the table maintenance. Done. So employee number, I'll give it as something 743. Employee name, I'll give it as what? Vivek. Designation, I'll choose supervisor. Department number, I'll choose something 30. I'll click on save. Good. Yeah, now I got the runtime error. Am I clear? So in SC level, it is not giving me the runtime error. Simply it is saying what? The data key is already available. But in case of table maintenance, I got a runtime error when I try to insert duplicate value for what? Employee name. So why we got the runtime error? Because a unique secondary index is configured on that particular column. What is the error I got? Open SQL array insert produces duplicate records in the database. Am I clear? So it is because of your what unique secondary index on what employee name column. Okay, done. So what we have done is we have created unique secondary index on what this particular table, which column employee name. This is what kind of table? This is client independent table. Doesn't have what client field. Now let me take one client dependent table. I'll take a table. Any table is there? One second. Oh, yeah, I'll take this table. Yeah, we have data also here. Done. Yeah, you can observe now. Already, you can see we have a what? Non-key field employee name. Non-key field employee name. Okay, and this table already contains duplicate values for what? Employee name. Already it contains duplicate values for employee name. So before that, let me generate the table maintenance for this also. So then I'll get the runtime error. Yeah, table maintenance is generated. Now, yeah. I want to create unique secondary index on what employee name, but this is what table client dependent table. So whenever we create unique secondary index on client dependent tables, the client field should be part of index. Okay, I repeat once again, whenever we try to create unique secondary index on client dependent tables, the client field should be part of the index. Means I cannot create unique secondary index only on employee name. It should be a combination of client field, that is MANDT and what employee name. So let's see whether it'll allow or not. So I'll choose it. How do you generate the index? Create the index, go to indexes. First of all, already employee name is in duplicate values. Raju is there twice. So it should not allow me to create unique secondary index. So I'll click on indexes. I'll click on create index. I'll give the index name something ID2. Done. Okay, I'll just give some description. Secondary index on what? Employee name. Now I'll go for what? Unique index. Yeah, field name. Let me choose what? What shall I choose? Yeah, I'll choose only what? Employee name. Field name, I'll choose only employee name. Done. Continue. Employee name I've chosen, done. Yeah, it should not allow me to create a unique index on this. There are two reasons, because this table is what table? Client dependent table. So client field should be part of this index, and apart from that, already this field contains what? Duplicate values. So it should not allow me to create unique index. Let me cross check. I'll save it, check for the syntax. Good. Yeah, what is the error I got? Client field required for what? Unique index. So what is the adjustment I have to do? I should also select what? MANDT field. So I'll select MANDT and what? Employee name. Done. Let me save. It is not giving me any error. I'll try to activate. Warnings occur during activation. Don't see the log. Okay. It is not giving much information over here. I'll do one thing. So what is saying is, see, it is active, but the index does not exist in the database system. I'll do one thing. Let me go back and activate my table. Check for the syntax. I'll try to activate. Good. Errors occurred when activating, refer to the log. So it is, table was not activated. But why? When I click on that, I didn't got any information. I'll click on this log. Any information on this? Table could not be what? Activated. Error adjusting the database. So I'm unable to activate here. Return code is what? 8 it seems. I am unable to activate. So I'll do one thing. I'll go to SC14. So in the log, I understood that it is unable to adjust the database. So I'll go to what? SC14. What is the table name? Z930_MP. I'll click on edit. Right. So here you can see I'm having a button activate and adjust the database. Let me check whether I can do the adjustment from here. I'll click on this request adjust. Yes. Convert tables on the, yeah, good. Yeah, here I got there. What is this here? See, the create unique index statement. The create unique index statement terminated because a duplicate key was found for the object so and so, and the index name is what? IV2. The duplicate key value is what? 800 and Raju. Good. Understood. I am unable to check the log in my SC11, but when I'm trying to adjust it from SC14, I got the detailed information. Okay. So this is how the index is created in the database internally. It is what database here? MS SQL. So this is a syntax they'll follow in that MS SQL might be. Okay. So what is the error I got? There is already duplicate value. So what I'll do now, I'll just go back to my table. I'll try to delete that duplicate entry. So I'll go to contents. Yeah, there is one duplicate Raju here. I'll choose this table entry. Okay. I don't have. Yeah, anyway, generally the table maintenance. No? So I'll go to SM30. Right. What is the table name? Table name is Z930_EMP. So I'll go to SM30. Z930_EMP, maintain, done. So Raju is already there. I'll choose this number of is what? 1. So there is no duplicate employee name. Done. Okay, so go back to the table. Yeah, this table contains what? An index. What is the index? ID2. What type of index? Unique index. Now I'll try to what? Adjust it from SC14. So I'll go to SC14. Okay, it is a utility tool for adjusting your database tables. Okay, so I'll choose what? Activate and adjust database. Request adjust, yes. Yeah, request for so and so is executed successfully. Done. Now I'll go to the table maintenance SM30 Z930_EMP. I'll click on maintain. Right, I'll click on new entries. I'll give the employee name something 98. I'll give the employee name. Employee what? Designation. Save it. Data was successfully saved. So we have how many records here? See, we have these records. Now already Kiran is there. I'll try to insert Kiran once again. So I'll give the employee number 120. I'll give Kiran. And I'll do something what? Employee. I'll try to save it. Control S. Yeah, again I got the error because we are having what? Unique secondary index on that particular table. Okay, so why do we create the indexes? To improve the performance of what? Select statement. Yeah, is it clear to everyone? Primary index and secondary index.
हेलो
या चिन्ना
సరే ఇప్పుడు ప్రైమరీ ఇండెక్స్ క్రియేట్ చేసుకోవచ్చు కదా టేబుల్ లెవెల్లో, సెకండరీ ఇండెక్స్ ఎందుకు క్రియేట్ చేసుకోవాలి? ఆల్రెడీ కస్టమ్ టేబుల్స్ కదా.
యు హావ్ జాయిన్డ్ లేట్ యు హావ్ జాయిన్డ్ లేట్ ప్రైమరీ ఇండెక్స్ ఈజ్ క్రియేటెడ్ బై SAP ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ వాట్ ప్రైమరీ క్యూ ఫీల్డ్. వీ నో దట్ ఇన్ SAP. యా ప్లీజ్ మ్యూట్ యువర్ స్పీకర్స్. యా సో ఆల్రెడీ we know that in SAP every table will have what minimum one primary key. Okay, so on top of that primary key field, SAP will automatically create what primary index. Okay, means internally it will arrange the data in the what in an in the primary key field order. Okay, it will arrange the data in the ascending order of what primary key field. So whenever we execute the select statement, comparing with what primary key field, SAP will automatically make use of what primary index. Understood? So whether it is custom table or standard table, primary index is always created by SAP itself based on what primary key field. As a developer, we can only create what secondary index, and we create them on what non-primary key fields. Is it clear, Chinna?
If we created, what will happen? Primary index again.
First of all,
one more
question. First of all, tell me, how do you create primary key index? Suppose this is a table. I want to create the primary index. Here, whatever the navigation we are having, okay, for clicking on this index, this is considered as secondary index. We don't have any option to create the primary index. Is it clear?
Okay. I'm primary key field. We can create one more primary key field.
One more primary key field, primary key index.
Primary key field.
You can create, we can have up to 16 primary key fields.
No problem. Suppose any duplication records.
If any duplicate records are there, obviously it will not allow me to create. So you have to ensure that there are no duplicate records. First delete those duplicate records, then you create what primary key, because primary key means what doesn't accept what duplicate value. So if already duplicate records are there, if you try to create primary what key field on that particular field, primary key on that particular field, it will not allow you to create. So you delete that duplicate records and create the primary key field. Like that I can create up to 16 primary key fields. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Acha, one more thing is, again, creating too many secondary index also is not recommended. Okay, there are two things here. Why do we create the secondary indexes? To improve the performance of your select queries. But creating too many secondary index also is not recommended. Too many means there is no specific like one or two kind of thing. As you are what creating n number of indexes, again the performance will degrade it. Why? Because assume that already some two secondary indexes are there. So what is the concept of index? It will arrange the data in an order based on that field. Again, if you create one more secondary index, what SAP has to do, again on that huge amount of data, it has to sort the data on the newly created secondary index field. So every time it has to swap the data, it has to sort the data in an order based on that particular secondary index. That's why it is recommended to create the secondary index. But again, creating too many secondary indexes also may degrade the performance. It will increase the load on the database, because every time it has to adjust the data in an order. That's the reason, again, don't create too many secondary indexes. How many we can create maximum? There is no restriction as such, but as you go on creating the indexes, obviously the load on the database server also will not increase. Okay, so we should be very careful when you are creating the secondary indexes. Done? Is it clear to everyone? Indexes concept, primary index and second index? And when do we go for non-unique secondary index? You want to arrange the data in order, but we should be able to enter the duplicate value also. At that time, we'll go for a non-unique. Okay, unique means which doesn't accept duplicate values. And we don't have any control on what primary index. We don't have any option to create what? Primary index. Whatever the index we create explicitly, it is always called as what? Secondary index. Okay. Again, creating secondary index on primary key field doesn't make sense. So remember, it will not give any error, but it doesn't make sense. Already indexing is there on that field. Unnecessarily, you are increasing the load on what? Database server. Done. Right. So in this only we have discussed currency, quantity fields and foreign key tables. Okay, before I'm going to that, yeah, let me cover a small topic. Yeah, we have something called as type group. Type group. Okay, so what is this type group means? Type group is a collection of global types and global what? Constants. It's a collection of what? Global types and global constants. So already we know at our program levels, we know how to do the types declaration. We know how to declare the constants. Okay. So if you declare any types or constants within a program, they're local to that program. Now I can use the types declaration variables or that constant variables only within that program. But assume that in your project, in many objects, I need to use the same types declaration or I need to use the same constants. So what we will do in the project is we will decide to create what? A type group. Again, understood? It's again a team decision. Okay, unnecessarily we should not create the type. If you feel that, okay, in many objects, same types declaration, same constants has to be reuse, then you'll go for what? Going for what? You'll go for creating the type group. So type group is what? It is a reusable dictionary object, which is a collection of what? Global types and what? Global constants. Just like we have many standard database tables, there are many standard type groups provided by SAP itself. I repeat, just like we have many standard database tables, there are many standard type groups given by SAP. For example, in this SC11, if I choose type group, I'll give the type group name as something CNDP. So you can see it is not starting with ZRY. So nothing but what? It is a standard type group provided by SAP. So if I display this, okay, it is a standard type group. So what does the type group contains? It contains a declaration of types and what? Constants. So you can see, we have types, we have constants. Like this, we can have only types and what? Constants. We cannot use any data keyword here. Understood? Generally, to declare the variables, we use data keyword, parameters keyword, types keyword, and constants. Inside the type group, I can use only types and what? Constants. So this is one of the type groups. Similarly, we have CNTL. CN what? TL. Again, this is another type group. So like this, there are many what? Standard type groups provided by SAP. Icon type group. Okay, we have a type group called as VRM. Like this, we have many standard type groups given by SAP. Okay, we can also create what? Our own type group. So once the type group is available, I can reuse it in what? N number of what? Repository objects. Just like already we know, if you want to use the variables of a include program in your repository object, what you'll do, you'll include the include program. How do we include? We use include keyword followed by what? Include program name. Similarly, whenever you want to use components of a type group, inside your repository object, we need to declare that type group by using what? Type pools keyword. Suppose I'm having one type group called as VRM. Okay, inside this, I'm having one types declaration, what? VRM underscore value. I want to use this particular types declaration in my report program. So what you have to do? you have to declare that type group by using what keyword? Tuples keyword. So tuples followed by what? VRM. Okay, like this, I can include n number of type groups, VRM, CNTL, like this, n number of type groups I can include in a single program. Okay, so this inclusion is mandatory till 6.0. Till 6.0. If you're working in the older version 4.6c, 4.6b, 4.7, and 6.0, compulsorily we have to declare the type group by using what keyword? Type pools keyword. Then only I can use the components of that particular type group. But from EHP version onwards, from EHP version onwards, okay, I need not explicitly include the type group. It is automatically recognized by SAP itself. So this declaration is mandatory till 6.0. But from EHP version onwards, even if you don't include the type group, I can directly use the components of a type group. So something like this here. Assume that we have some custom type groups, okay? Custom type groups like Z, A, B, C, Z, P, Q, R, blah, 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 something like this, okay? And we have many standard type groups. So what is the type group can contain? It can contain constants and types. So once a type group is available, I can include it in any number of repository objects. So when I say repository object, it can be an executable program, it can be an include program, or it can be subroutine pool, whatever it is. How do we include it? By using the keyword type pools. Type pools followed by type group name. So this declaration is mandatory till 6.0. From EHP version onwards, without declaring also, I can directly use the components of the type group. Okay. And one more point you have to understand is the naming standard for these components. Whatever the components you declare in the type group, those components name must prefix with type group name followed by underscore. Must prefix with type group name followed by underscore. For example, if I take this type group VRM. So what is the name of the type group? VRM. If I display this, you can see this. What is the name starting with? Type group name followed by underscore. Okay. See another declaration. Type group name followed by underscore. So compulsorily, when we create our own type group also, we must follow this naming standard. Means all the components of the type group, all the components names of the type group must prefix with what? Type group name followed by underscore. Okay. So let me quickly create the type group. I'll give the type group name as something ZABC, some type group. Since it is a custom, I'm starting with Z. Create, it's already existing. So I'll give it as something ZAB. Create short text. Provide the short text. Some short text. Done. So this is my type group ZAB. So inside this, what are the keywords permitted? Only types keyword and what? Constant keyword. Suppose I'll say data x type I. I'm trying to declare a variable x by using data keyword. When I do syntax check, I got an error. What is that? Within a type pool, you can only define what? Types and what? Constants. So this is rolled out. So this will give me what? What? Syntax error. Then I'll say data. Sorry. Let me use constants. I'll say x type I. Okay. So when I do syntax check, again, I got a. Let me initialize. So I'll say value 10. But still, I'll get an error because the component name is not starting with what? Type group name. So when I do syntax check, I got an error. All names of the objects called ZAB in the current type pool must begin with the prefix what? ZAB underscore. So again, this is giving me what? Syntax error. Right? So compulsory, you have to start with what? The name of the type group followed by underscore. So when I do syntax check, I don't have any errors. Okay, so like this, I can declare n number of constants and n number of types declaration. Right, done. Next, I can declare what types also. So types, I'll say here also begin of what ZAB underscore what EMP. Compulsory you have to start with what name of the type group followed by underscore. Employee number type I, then also what employee name of 20 type C. So like this, I can declare n number of constants and n number of what types declaration. Done. So when I do syntax check, no errors. It's activated, right? It's activated. So I want to use this type group in my repository object. Okay, so after activating, I'll just create one program. Executable program. So now what I'll do, oh yeah, one of the constant, what is the constant name? ZAB underscore X is my constant name. So I'll say write what ZAB underscore X, right? So what is the value I'm expecting? 10. So when I do syntax check, I don't have any errors. When I execute also, I got the result as 10. If you execute the same thing in ECC 6.0 or before lower version, okay, you'll get an error saying that this is unknown. But this is what version? What is the server I'm using? EHP 7. So this is, even if you don't declare, it works fine. But in the older versions, what you have to do? You have to use the keyword type pools. Type pools, what is the name of the type group? ZAB. Okay, you have to declare the type group by using what type pools keyword. Okay, but here it is not required. So I'll just comment here. So this is what mandatory till what 6.0. Similarly, I can use a types declaration. Okay, I'll create a work area data W underscore EMP type. What is that? ZAB underscore EMP. So I can directly use the components without declaring the type group. In the older versions, I must include the type group. I must declare the type group by using what keyword? Type pools keyword. That's all. These are the only points related to what? A type group or type pools. Any questions? So I repeat once again, how do we define a type group? A type group is a reusable dictionary object, which is a collection of global types and global constants. As part of the type group, only types and constant declarations are supported. And another point is, all the components in the type group must follow the naming standard. What is the naming standard? The component name must prefix with name of the type group followed by underscore. The name of the type group followed by underscore. And if you want to use the components of the type group in the repository objects, we need to declare the type group by using what keyword? Type pools keyword. This declaration is mandatory till 6.0. Okay, from ESP version onwards, I can directly use the components of the type group without declaring the type group. That's all. That is about the type group. Okay, so tomorrow what we'll do is, on the database tables, we will see how to create foreign key relationship and how to work with currency and what quantity fields, how to link two tables. So that part we'll discuss tomorrow. Done. So I'll wind up for today. We'll continue tomorrow. Chalo.